All right, it's Friday, the first week of buck season in Pennsylvania. And so the deer have been pressured for several days, and they're not really, really pressured. They're semi-pressured. After tomorrow, when the doe season comes in, they'll really be pressured. But this is a good time through the end of the week, the first week, to really sneak up on some deer. You want to find those historical places that when them deer get a little bit pressured, they go and run and hide to. So basically, you're going to follow along with me. I'm going to show you what I do on how to hunt these whitetail deer in Clarion County, Pennsylvania. What I'm using is a Savage 243, bolt action, just with an old Tasco scope. This thing is, I don't know, they don't make Tascos like they used to, I guess, because this thing, scope's been on forever. But this was my first deer rifle. This is the gun Danielle uses. And I tell you what, 243 is a perfect caliber to get started in hunting and to keep hunting with it throughout your whole life, because I tell you what, 243 puts them down pretty good. So just follow along with me and we're going to see if we can sneak up on some deer. This is the food plot where I killed my buck last year. Got a real nice scrape right here, right underneath this tree. We're gonna sneak up along the creek. You know you're in good buck territory when you start seeing shreds of bark off the tree from these rubs. Just doing a little bit of walking around, trying to get to the places where I want to try to sneak up on the deer. Found a little shed. You see, look how open the woods is. And you can spot deer. Openness. Just stop, walk slow, and just scan. And I caught a little bit of a flicker of a tail. So there's a deer there. And if there's one, there's probably more. Alright, so those deer are maybe 100 yards, and you know, you just want to sneak through, just scan, walk really, really slow, and you can pick up those deer in the wide open. There's very little brush. Use the trees to your advantage. And you know, another thing is, I said last year in a video about wearing the color orange, I did not mean that deer can see the color orange, therefore being able to pick you out. What I meant was, is with the color orange, and see how it's a solid head, those tones are going to stick out. They're going to be more noticeable to the deer. Not that they see color, but that they pick up the tones and the movement. And so you also, even with your camo, you want different shades of camo. I have real dark hardwoods on my top and real light hardwoods on my bottom. So even my camo is to help break up my outline. Do you see that white? See, you can't even see the deer, but it's that kind of stuff right there that you want to be able to pick up from a long, long ways away. You want to be able to pick up on that stuff. And you even want to be able to see the deer going this way in the woods, and the trees are going this way. That's another way you can tell, you know, it may not be a rock and it may not be a log. It could be a deer. And it's those little fine details that's going to make the difference whether you see the deer first or the deer see you first. You have spotted that. No white, just brown, walking out this open trail. You can see how open it is, okay? And that's probably 100 yards. And looking at those tones, even the deer is this way and the trees are this way, just simple stuff like that. Usually if you see one deer, most of the time they group up when they get pressured. So I'm just gonna look behind it, watch to see if that deer keeps looking back. Most likely if it's by itself, it's a button buck, because it doesn't look like a very big deer. So I'm just gonna sit here and wait a little while, and if I don't see it, I'm going to spook the deer. I can't move without spooking that deer, and it's just kind of hanging out there. So if I don't see anything else and I feel confident that I'm not gonna see any other deer in that area, I will spook it to get to other places where I know the deer are at. Okay, so I just bumped one doe that I did not see. She was hiding down over this bank, which I was trying to get there. But it heard me before, you know, it never saw me. It heard me come up running up out of here. Now, the other doe that I spooked up there, they have all gone, even with those turkeys, have all gone out in front of me. The problem is now they're going to be looking back at me. So here's the difficult thing. A lot of people will not do this because it's a pain. I'm going to do a half moon circle. Gonna come out and get in front of those animals. Now those deer are not super spooked. They're only gonna be just walking very slowly. Once they get out of sight, and they haven't really seen me, they've heard me, they're just gonna slowly start walking. They're gonna start using the wind to smell me. I'm gonna drop down over, use the creek as my sound buffer, and I'm gonna follow along this steep ridge and come up, hopefully, in front of those deer. It doesn't happen all the time, but I've done it lots of times before where you'll be surprised how many more deer are out in front of you if you can catch up to them. And you have to sort of do this somewhat quick, and it's pretty steep. So I'm going to drop down over, run along the creek, come up the other side, maybe 300 yards out, and come up. I saw on the second day, that 8 point, 40 yards, and he moved. He's just out there about 75 now, but I could have easily killed him, and that's what happens. If you can, you understand what the deer are going to do, you can sneak out, come right up on him. You can see the tram road down here, and I come up from the creek and come straight up, and this is a historical spot. I have always come up this same little path. I have just learned over time that you want to find those historical lines that you can always take and always be sure that you're going to be ahead of the deer. I have spooked deer from that other side where I saw those turkeys before. I've done this exact same thing years ago and have come right up and have gotten shots of deer right where I'm standing right now. And I've done it the opposite way. I've come up here, deer have seen me, they go out that way. I come down and we circle down around in front of them and get in front of them, and we can get a shot that way too. So that buck, he's not real spooked, because his head was behind a tree when I first crawled up here. The doe took off running, he ran out that way, just looked back, and I just didn't move. So he's just kind of slowly walking out there. He just can't seem to pinpoint me. The wind's going the wrong way for him to smell me, so. He just doesn't know what to make of me, because I'm not moving and he can't smell me. That's funny. So I have basically dropped back down. I'm not going to push those deer anymore. My main goal is to seek out those historical places where the deer like to hide when they get pressured. All you guys who archery hunt and then quit hunting after the rifle season, you're not going to know where those are unless you hunt after rifle season, after the majority of the hunters have left the woods and hunt that flintlock season. I tell you what, if you want to become a better hunter, hunt the flintlock season. So you just want to keep going and sneak up on those places as slowly. If it takes you an hour to walk 50 yards, if that's what it takes, that's what's, you know, you're going to have to do that in order for them not to see you, hear you, or smell you. Always figure out where the wind is going to go. This is proof with the camera that you can get in front of deer. When you bump deer, don't start pushing them and walking and trying to sneak up on them with the, you know, walking through the woods like this. You know, my gun has been on my back the entire time, and I'm hunting with the camera. This is only in case the next world record steps out, because I'm really not planning on killing a buck. I see a buck. I just come down, snuck up around from where I was just talking, another 300 to 400 yards, and got up over on top. And look, now, I'm telling you, I can't believe I spotted this. But I see a buck laying down. So here's my view. Okay. Now, if you look right here. This deer has no idea how lucky it is. I'm pretty sure that's the same buck. I spooked him and he went and laid down, and he is just laying right there in that thick stuff. That is awesome. That I'm just really fortunate today is really going what I wanted to show, is actually showing how to sneak up on these deer. Because not every time I go in the woods, it's like this, but I'm just showing you, using your eyes and your ears and looking for those little tiny details. I mean, when I look up there, it looked like just like a light colored leaf. And I zoomed in with the camera instantly. I could see him turn his head. Awesome.
Well, there's one reason why the deer aren't moving very well. There's a pretty good size acorn. That thing's pretty big. Lots of acorns in the woods. So deer should be pretty fat for winter this year.
Well, there's just some stuff that I'm just never gonna see a deer in, like what's behind me. I'll never see one unless I step on it. But I'm gonna try to get up here to look down into my food plot, but I think I'm gonna head back to the truck. I think it was a pretty good successful day. I got to see some deer, turkeys, just take a nice walk through the woods with the gun. You know, it's not, hunting isn't always about killing. It's just enjoying to be out in the woods, and seeing a deer is a bonus, and killing a buck is a jackpot. So